This conference will now be recorded.
Hi, good morning, everyone. I hope you are doing good. And thanks for your strong support to all of my videos. I hope you are watching my videos. If you don't know the concept, you can learn from the videos. If you know the concept, please share with your SAP circle. Someone will get benefit because everyone may not know everything. So there are a lot of junior level or mid-level people can get more benefit out of my videos. Please like my videos and share. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please click on subscribe button. Okay, today I'm coming to you with the topic, how to edit custom or standard table in SAP. Okay, and when to edit, that cases might be very less, but this video will concentrate on how to edit a table. In my experience, I never edited a standard table. Okay, I never get a that kind of requirement, but I had in a few cases that in case of handling unit management or some 2-3 cases I saw in our colleagues or some different projects where there is no other option to update the data through the transaction. At that point of time, take a special permission and the what is the reason, everything, and then they edit the table to update the data. So that kind of things can happen. And custom table, yes, custom table in my last warehouse management implementations, we had some custom table where we update the data, especially the serial numbers are not linked with warehouse management. So we have a custom table to link the storage bin quantity, everything with the serial number. In that customized tables, we had got a couple of requirements. A couple of times we need to update the table. We need to refresh the data with some kind of a data which is missing. We need to update those kind of things we have done. But standard table, I have not done any point of time in my almost 8.5 years of SAP consulting experience. Okay, let's go to that topic, how to edit custom or standard table in SAP. So that's what I mentioned here. In any special case, we may get the requirement to edit a table in SAP to update the data when there is no other option to update the data through transaction. We always need to update it. For example, if you create a material that MERA or MERC, these tables will be updated. If you go and change a data, that table will be updated. So that's what we know. If you do any transaction, change or create or delete the data, in these kind of activities we do through transactions, then the tables will be updated. That's what we see. It should happen in that way. We should not update the table directly. It's like a manipulation. Okay, without doing course, getting certificate, or without going to the office, doing what you call swiping from your desk by using some other methods. So these are all this kind of activities. So always it should happen through transaction. In very special cases, maybe some 2 years old document you wanted to update, but system is not allowing because it's all the archive. Any kind of special cases at that point of time, we may use this one. Like I mentioned, I never get a requirement to update the standard table, but custom table, we did it. Even the legally, this is not recommended because it always should happen, right? I should create a material, then only the table should be updated. I cannot update the table directly. Okay. So legally, it's not recommended. So we will not have this authorization in production system. If you go to the production and if you try to do this, this will not be available. Okay, so if you have any valid reason, that is the only option. We don't have any other option. Transactions are not working, and through transactions we are not able to update. At that point of time, we may have to take the special permission from the manager, and we have to give the valid reason what happened, what we tried, what we is not happening, and even we rise to SAP, but SAP resolution was not applicable, or any kind of valid reason, and then only we need to take the special permission to update the standard table. Okay, this is the topic, it's a generic I'm saying, because we cannot give, I have not seen any case exactly where we have to update the standard table because we have a transactions to update the data. Okay, let's go to the the main topic is in the how to edit the table. So these are the process steps. Go to SS16N and then input the table and then give slash h. Okay, after that execute, system will give you the debugging screen. There we need to give this gd edit and gd sap edit, and that value you should give capital X only. Okay, now click on execute button. Then whatever changes you want to do, you can just make the changes and click save button, and then you can come back. You can come back completely. If you click back again, then it's fine, or else you can just give slash n in the menu bar to come out of the debugging. Just the screen completely disappeared. Okay, let's go to the step. For this training purpose, I have taken the best example, which will not have any controversy. Generally, the people who uses what you call IDS system or any kind of a old system you have taken, or else you have taken some online SAP system for just practice purpose. At that point of time, if you take some company codes, the period of that company code will be very old, maybe 2003 or 2001 or 2006. So if you want to really open the period, you have to go to MMPV and close by period by period, period by period, you have to do that one. So at that point of time, you can directly change the table to come to 2020 without wasting that time. Okay, anyway, I was thinking what could be the table which is suitable for my training. So I selected this table, so no controversy. I cannot give a demo for MERA or MERC because the table data should be updated. Okay, let's see, we are talking more about MERA and all, right? I'm taking a material 234 in MERA table. The description is whatever the data, the material group, okay. And see, HTSO4 70% is concentrated. Okay, now I'm going to MM02. I'm giving 234. Go to basic data 1. 70% is concentrated. I change it to H2SO4. 50% is concentrated. Okay. Save. Once you change the material, the table will be updated. That's what we know. That should be the process. We should always initiate the changes from the transaction, and table is the backend where the data will be updated based on our activity, like based on the material changes in activity and PO changes in activity. Based on that, the table should be updated. Okay, now I updated. Let's refresh. Okay, then go to the end. Still not yet updated. Okay. See, HTSO4 50% is concentrated. It is the table supposed to be updated in that way. We should not be editable directly. That's what I wanted to say. So I have taken this table as a best example to teach you. I'm going to MMRV to see the posting period of my company code GKCC. If you see that posting period, the period was 2003 and previous period was 2003. Some, it was very old data are available, and you wanted to take to 2020 to use that company code for your transactions. At that point of time, what is our method? We have to go to MMPV and close one by one, one by one. 2003 to 2020, 17 years into 12. Okay, almost you have to do for more than 170 times. So we will teach you how to do this one through table update. Go to SC16N. The table is MARV. So MARV is the table which will hold this posting, the period data. Go to MARV, click enter, then give your company code. Now click on slash, give slash h, and click enter. So once you click enter, what happened? You can see that one message at the bottom, debugging switched on. We are just switching on the debugging. Now go to execute button. Okay, in this variable field, we need to give gd edit gd sap edit. So you have to give gd edit and gd sap edit, then go to this change button. You should give only capital X, okay, because small x I think it's not working, so always give capital X. Now click on execute. See, now you can see the table is in editable way. Now what I want to do, I will change to 2020, previous period is 4, 2020 is the financial year. Okay, now save it. Once you save, you can automatically check from here itself, MMRV. See, the periods are updated. Now you are allowed to post in May 2020. You can post the document. So I updated the table data now. And from here itself, you can just click slash n, or else you can go back and just click slash n. So what is the benefit of slash n? The debugging screen, everything was disappeared. Okay. Here you can just, no need to then give slash n in the menu bar and click enter to come out of debug. Just need to come out of the screen, you can do this one. So these are the simple process steps. Whenever you want to edit a table, it can be a standard or custom table. Mostly custom table edits happen very frequently because those tables are being updated through our programs, and the program has some issue and the table is not updated properly. So we need to manually update the table. So in case of standard tables, mostly the requirement will not come because the standard tables are being updated based on our transactions like material creation or PO creation or goods receipt, these kind of all activities. So you can correct, you can do the posting of that activity, or you can create that activity like material creation or PO creation and update the table. Okay, but you don't have to edit the table. Okay, I don't recommend anyway. In production, we will have we will not have any access for these kind of activities. In special cases, we may go for that, but customize the table. Whoever working on custom tables, definitely you connect to my words, because custom tables are being updated based on a custom program. Okay, if it is being updated, you got an issue for the custom program and it was rectified after 1 to 1.5 days or 1 to 2 days. During this point of time, there are some entries are not updated in the custom table. Once you fix the program, that 2 days data you wanted to update or you wanted to update the custom table with the missing data, which is supposed to be updated in this 1 to 2 days. At that point of time, we use this method to update the table. Okay. So the overall, we learned in this video how to edit a custom or a standard table in SAP. When to edit, like I told you, that cases are, we cannot exactly tell how, when such kind of situation will happen for a standard table, but custom table, it can happen in the during initial days when the programs are having some issues, not yet stabilized, we got some different issues. At that point of time, we can use the same. I hope this session is helpful for you. And this video is not limited to any specific module in SAP. This video is helpful for all SAP functional consultants and also ABAP consultants. But ABAP consultant, mostly they would aware this because they know more and more things. This is very small thing for them. But anyway, if any ABAP consultants are also, if they don't know, just understand from here. And I hope this is a generic video for all SAP functional consultants. I hope most of you people will utilize this video. Thanks for your time and have a good day.